I'm Kip Guy. I'm the Dean of the College of Pharmacy at the University of Kentucky. My research focuses on discovering and developing new drugs for neglected diseases, especially those of children. So we were working on a system that cells use to get rid of old proteins. If you don't get rid of the garbage, just like in your house, things get really messy and don't work very well. So there's an elaborate control mechanism for doing this in cells, and it goes on every day in every cell. One of the things that goes wrong in cancers is often problems in this pathway. And those can manifest with proteins that should be gone, hanging around and continuing to drive the cell to do things like grow and divide. So as a control mechanism, it's been of interest for a long time. There were drugs available that would really shut down the whole process. And those are toxic because they affect all cells. So we were interested in whether or not we could be more specific in controlling that process. We thought what was going to happen was we would get a compound which would affect cancer cells that had a defect in that particular part of the pathway, where they would kill those cells, but they would leave alone all the other cells. We got a really nice compound that does exactly what we want in the control mechanism. It has all the effects we wanted on cells, except they don't die. So we stepped back for a minute. Does this not do what we think? Does it not work the way we think? We figured out relatively quickly that while we didn't kill the cells, we prevented them from being metastatic. So they couldn't grow outside the context of a tissue. Our very specific compound in this very general process had a very specific effect against cancers. It just wasn't the one we were expecting. In a lot of cancers, it's not the primary lesion that kills you. It's often the metastatic lesions. And so being able to block that, if we can do that in a way that's really effective and safe, that could be a game changer in a lot of tumors. Lung is probably one of those. It's a really exciting thing. People have talked about doing this for a long time. And now whether or not we're going to be able to convert that into a drug that's usable in the clinic, that's a long road to go down. But it's an exciting road to be on. I currently have a drug in clinical trials for malaria. So that's 12 years of work. And that team has members on every continent. I realized I was pretty good at organizing people. And I realized I was getting much more interested in how we implement the output of the science in addition to actually doing the science myself. So I started looking for opportunities where I could have a bigger influence on picking the problems that people focused on as a group, on really trying to make those practically relevant, especially to the things I care about, which are big health disparities and underserved populations. I wanted to be in a place where I could help to combine the way we teach and not only research, but the way we teach clinical practice. So that motivated me pretty hard to start looking at dean positions. And it's one of the strongest colleges in the country. It's one of the strongest colleges in the world. It's hard not to be attracted here. In addition, for me, it's smack in the middle of an area where we have really high health disparities, some of the worst in the US. I can work the way I want to work with the kinds of people who are here, the amazing faculty we've got in the college, and focus on problems that are really serving unmet needs. We have a long history of really innovative education here, and I want to make sure that we continue to grow and innovate, both in teaching pharmacy practice and also in teaching pharmaceutical sciences and research. I want to make sure that as a college, we engage in interprofessional and interdisciplinary research, especially in areas where it serves unmet needs. And then I want to make sure that we continue to have a broadly inclusive and service-oriented culture. We're not just about working in the lab or the clinic. We're also about living in this community and doing well by it.